Continue with our Facebook Live 20. Yes, 20th episode. And yes, welcome again. And my name is Sangwa.
And I'm Anson, and we're from Eason Music.
Yes.
So for those who's not familiar with Eason Music, we're a Chinese instrumental shop that sells Chinese instrument. We teach Chinese instrument. We do repairs for Chinese instrument. We also rent Chinese instrument. And finally, we do performances for live events and company events as well.
Yes, and every Friday we will be doing a Facebook Live at 5:30, and today's been delayed, so sorry about it again. Mm-hmm. And what we'll do is we will have a quick chat about what's happening in the latest Chinese orchestra scene, and we'll just show you a little bit of what came in over the week, and of course, we will have a special performance at the end of the session, and today is very special as well because we have a special guest.
Yes, so the special guest we have today is Indra, and she'll be sharing with us alternative ways of playing the Guzheng. So do look forward to it.
Yes, and for the incoming, actually we have the Erhu protective tape for the
Erhu snake skin protective tape.
Yeah, Erhu snake skin protective tape. So do stay tuned for that as well.
Yeah, okay, so let's just get right to it.
So just get right into it. So the latest happening in Singapore, Chinese music scene this week, is also coincide with what our special guest today. So without further ado, she's one of our most versatile guzheng players in Singapore today. She has left a mark in many different genre of music, and she has even appeared in many parts of Singapore doing ensemble performance and outdoor gigs. She also appeared in a two-set violin video. Yes.
Of course, Indra, we've worked together for a very long time.
Yes,
I always get her to for some performances, and she is one of the most versatile guzheng players that I've seen. I mean, a lot of guzheng players,
are good, but none as versatile as our guest.
Yes.
So let us welcome the fabulous Indra!
Hi!
Hello, everyone!
Hi, Indra, how are you?
Yeah, okay, I'm good. How are all of you?
We're trying to calm down right now.
Yeah, we're a bit flustered. So, Indra, what's happening lately with you?
Okay, I just completed a project that Gilden invited me to go on board with. It's called Shiyun, that is presented by Arts House. It is called Poetic Rhymes.
Poetic Rhymes.
Yeah. So it is a show, actually not exactly a show, okay? It is just a program with poems, okay?
But when can we watch the...
Tomorrow, 10 a.m. I'll tell you more.
Later. Okay, yeah.
Okay. It's curated by Dr. Tan Chi Le.
Okay.
And the music is actually directed by Gilden.
Gilden is... Gilden Chu is one of the guests that we had earlier on. Yeah, so...
And,
difference.
Yeah, music produced by Lalit Kumar. Yeah. So actually, my role in that project, I was just a musician.
Okay.
Together with Cai Xia and Govin. Cai Xia and Govin. Yeah. So actually, our role was something similar to today's topic, all on crafting, composing, not exactly just being an instrumentalist.
Okay.
So what Gilden taught us to do was to sat down together, brainstorm, and craft different poems, compose themes.
Craft as in
like
in
really
what form?
Write
you write poems.
No.
In Chinese.
We receive poems from Dr. Tan. Then from there we
construct
will
construct the music based on
correct
the poem
on the meaning of the poem from the tone, like how the How they read the poem lah.
Okay.
Yeah, so basically we will start composing.
Is it like newly composed music, or you guys base on like existing works or some sort?
Only one piece with that's existing. Lao Liu Ban, Mi Mi La Rei Do. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Apart from that, everything else I've newly composed.
So what can we look out for, look forward to from this show? Like anything special, any highlights that.
And so our songs, our ideas,
Okay. Yeah, you compose a few, is it? Or
I compose two only, yeah.
Two teams,
yeah.
Songs. Mm. Like what do you mean? You?
But my bandmates helped me. Like, oh, they interpreted the piece together with me.
You know? So you sat together and you read the poem and you think that how this song...
We think that it should sound like, how does it feel? A lot of feelings and the tone,
how
expression.
How are you feeling
now? Yeah, a lot of tone, a lot of expression.
Is it a solo or it's an ensemble piece?
For me, for the one that I wrote, I actually wrote it for the Zhongran to play. Mm. Yeah, it's just a very short theme that's played by Cai Xia.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I thought it's beautiful. Like, for she did it really beautiful. Like, I didn't even expect that. Wow, can sound so good. Yeah,
sounds
like,
so good.
Yeah, and when Cai Xia played that, Cai Xia, you're very good. So yeah.
Yeah, so back to the question, where or how can we watch this show?
Okay, it's
or performance.
It's on Arts House website.
Okay.
And tomorrow 10 AM, find it on at Arts House website. So there's actually a program booklet,
okay,
in English and Chinese that you can download from their website.
Okay, okay. So it's an online show.
Shiin 2020.
Yeah, so it's like not a physical live that we can watch.
So it's like...
I think it's on Spotify.
Oh, okay.
Mm.
So is it a video thing? Or it's
not? No.
Oh, it's an audio thing.
Audio thing.
Oh,
no,
okay.
Not
okay,
video
okay.
Thing.
Mm. Like podcast like that.
So we go to the website and we listen to it, then we download the program and we also can read and
you
know
can
more
read
about
the poems.
Oh, so
yeah.
That's how it should
okay.
Be.
So will it be there for a period of time or it's like permanently there?
I think it will be there for a period of time.
Okay, good.
So 10 AM is the launching time.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So
yeah,
watch
we'll leave a link at the description when our live ends. So
yes.
Our fellow viewers can go. Our live ended a few times already. Yeah, so we'll leave a link later when our live session ends. So you can check it out tomorrow 10 AM at Art House,
Art House website.
Mm. Yeah. Okay, so just now we also mentioned that you appeared in Two Set Violins video. Yeah, so why were you there?
Oh, because my friend is Two Set Violins friend.
Your
so,
friend is Two Set Violins.
Yeah,
okay.
So my friend is Yi Tong, I'm not sure if you know who she is. She's called Yi Tong.
No.
Yeah, so she I think Pili knows Yi Tong. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so
sing
some.
Huh? Sing some.
Yi Tong. Tan.
Okay.
Tan, right? Yeah. So she asked me if I'm interested in the collaboration. So
okay.
I said, of course. It's like
it's too surprising.
Yeah,
it's
too surprising.
They can judge my playing later.
Yeah. So it was actually very last minute. Everything was quite last minute. Like
okay.
So let's go. Find a studio, and then find Guzheng's. Then okay, let's go.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
she got all her cameras, her video cameras, and then set up. Bam bam bam. Okay, teach them Guzheng. Yeah.
Mm, so are they fast learners?
They are very fast. Very amazing.
How was it like teaching them?
They're very comical. Like even off camera they are also very comical, very
so
funny.
What we watch on live is really what they
yes,
are.
It's
person.
What they are.
Oh, it's like not it's not an actor's really.
Yeah, so they are very fast. They pick up fast as well and they think very fast as well. Like they know how on the spot they can think of. They can turn ideas immediately and yeah, to capture a lot of things for people to learn.
Yeah, so we heard that they are their own production crew also.
Mm,
yeah. So they think fast, they learn fast, but they also do a lot of editing work on their own as well.
Yes.
Yeah, we can definitely learn from them.
Amazing, they're amazing really. Like,
yeah. So you teach them how to play and anything else? Do you all like hang out together?
We had lunch together. After our whole
did they attract a lot of like looking eyes or like oh my god it's them?
I think so.
Actually my girls are also fans of
Railing's a big fan.
My students are also like big fans of Suspect.
Yeah, they're quite amazing.
They
so I think they shared your Instagram link at their video there. Did you like suddenly get a lot of people?
Yeah, in flux. Wow.
I want to learn Guzheng from you.
Then
teach
I went
me
to
Indra.
Then I went to unprivate my account.
You went to what?
Unprivate. Wow.
Yeah, initially
someone,
I was private.
Like absorb some of the limelight.
Yeah, initially I was private.
Away.
Then suddenly like, wow, so many people added me right there. I'm like, okay, then I'll just unprivate.
Did they still continue following you or?
I think so. Oh. I'm not sure.
But you hardly post anything on Instagram, right?
I tried.
You should use the opportunity to.
That's why now I created my Indra Music Diary. Indra's Music Diary.
Yeah. Oh, okay. It's on Instagram?
No, it's Facebook. On Facebook.
Okay, then we shall leave a link there so you can follow Indra.
Yeah, but that
link, on Two Set Violins video.
That link wasn't associated with Two Set Violins, right?
So, no, because at that point of time, I didn't have this Facebook page.
So what do you usually post there?
All the very videos of myself, like playing the Guzheng or
So actually, since we're on the topic of playing Guzheng, it's a good segue to get into our main topic for today, which is playing Guzheng using in alternative ways.
Yeah, so yes. Actually why we wanted, why we invited Indra here, because Indra is a little bit different from
a bit wacky,
traditional Guzheng players.
Yeah,
so she has a lot of creative ideas, you know, when you perform a pop song, you know, you need some creative ideas, you need to think out of the box, you need to think out of the Chinese orchestra mode that you
have. Yeah, how do you sound pop?
So she has a lot of ideas. So today we want to pick her brain to share some of the things that she usually does when she's playing like pop songs.
Yes.
So opening up my brain.
Or we can maybe we can
actually
take
I
a look
learned
at
this from, yeah, okay, from yeah. a lot of teachers around, especially one of my teacher that actually helped me a lot in this is Kailin. I'm not sure if you know the
violinist.
Kailin, he taught me a lot. He taught me how to improvise. Although I'm not strong at improvisation at all, but he taught me a lot of things that I can take note of, and I can learn sounds that I should listen to. Yeah, all this long.
Like stylistic expression.
Then a lot of sounds that I can explore, not just playing on. I can do a lot of percussive sounds, things that I should try.
Okay.
Like even singing and playing at the same time. Yeah, but it's still something that I don't really.
Are you gonna do that later?
Are you gonna sing?
No, I cannot. No, we will leave that to be.
Okay, so yeah. she touched on percussive sound. So let's look into that. So what kind of percussive sound can you usually do on a Guzheng? I'm not saying Yangqing. On a Guzheng.
Okay, so usually I like to imitate like how we can have, I wouldn't say a drum set, but I can have a
like
stronger
bass. Okay.
So I like to do like this and.
Okay, so you fist the Guzheng. Then you slap the Guzheng.
You punch the Guzheng. When you punch the Guzheng, it's like
punch is this. Ouch, cannot.
Yeah, you use the meteor, like the flashy side.
Okay,
yeah, like that also can use this part.
So that's like the bass drum, right?
Yeah.
Then the side would be like the snare, right?
So yeah, I try my best to. I'm trying to find the closest.
So you'll be playing on your left hand?
So for example,
that's very good actually. This is the intro that we're talking about. Yeah, so there must be a lot of coordination going on. So it's like you have in the beginning of learning Guzheng, you already have to know how to coordinate both left and right hand already, right? So transitioning to this phase of like playing percussive and playing on your left hand, was it difficult or like?
I think it's more of the this thing.
But it's like
hitting
playing the piano, right? Piano left and right hand.
Just
like imagine,
the
instead of using your finger, you're like slapping the, you're like
and
punching
you're just
the piano.
The pulse somewhere, maybe instead of using tapping your feet or like your like both feet, or you are just keeping the pulse on your using your right hand.
So your left hand is usually used to play chords, right?
Accompaniment.
Yeah, rather than the melody, right? So in this way, this is the rhythm and this one is the
accompaniment.
Yeah, so just now before we were preparing, right, I noticed that Indra was also scratching something.
Oh, okay. This is like shaker. I would like to say, I think it's like... No, guiro. Is it a guiro?
The...
The
frog thing, is it?
You know the rat?
The back of the frog thing.
No,
no, I think it's a guiro, right?
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Is it?
No, is it? Yes, it is.
Guiro, right? Uh-huh. Yeah.
Guiro. Yeah, so how do you fit into...
So, okay, I like to do... Or sometimes shaker, like, I can do it like...
I'm very fascinated right now.
Those of you who cannot see, she's actually using the fingers to actually
scratch the side
where the strings are.
Yeah, where the strings go into the string hole.
Yeah.
Yeah, then there's this part. Yeah, so I noticed on your left hand, right, you're also doing a lot of muting action also.
Yeah, so usually...
Yeah, it's just like quintessential pop essence also.
I'm trying to... As in, because I heard this on like Despacito, you know they use... keyboard. I think it's keyboard.
Okay.
They have this.
So this is like a very common Guzheng playing technique.
Yeah, it is very common. It's just that I think people
don't usually use it.
Yeah, or? Because of the muting part that makes it different. Different from normal. Maybe there are, it's just that I'm not aware.
Does it exist in traditional classical pieces? This
I know some people have to use it.
Yes, there are, but not in this way.
Yeah, not in a rhythmic way.
Not in a rhythmic and like
because you're always playing melodic
accompaniment way. Yeah, because you're always playing melodic phrases.
Yeah, so I also realized that because Guzheng is always changing in pentatonic, right? So it's do, re, mi, sol, la. So, and chord is always changing, you know, like especially the fourths and the seventh, like that. So, the when there's fas and tis, right? And you're doing so many things, you're slapping, you're hitting, and you're also playing, right? Then, how can you like press the strings? Or do you have to do a different tuning?
I tune the strings, yeah.
So, for our benefit of our viewers, what do you usually tune your Guzheng to? Like what notes? Not saying keys, like what notes?
For the lower octave, for it depends lah, but usually for the lowest mi, the 3 mi, right, I'll tune it to fa, so I can achieve like
fa la.
Chord 4.
Okay.
Because a lot of pop songs got chord 4 ma. Yeah, without chord 4, sometimes chord 4 and chord 2 sounds very different. So sometimes I prefer using chord 4. Yeah, it depends lah, but most of the time I tune my mi to chord 4. Then the mi, right, I will use one octave higher than the lower.
So if you strum it now, how do we sound like?
Now this is in C. Okay. I'm tuned to in C pentatonic now. So this is re, fa, sol, la, do. Re, fa, sol, la, do. Instead of re, mi, sol, la, do. So the normal C pentatonic tuning on the Guzheng should be re, mi, sol, la, do. But now I tune the mi to fa.
Yeah, so you also mentioned that you're tuned into C right now. So meaning if you do gigs or anything, right, you have to stick to one key only, or you have to bring another Guzheng.
I can change in between, but it'll take time lor.
But most of the time, if you have a very short time,
just try to stick to D. Yeah.
So everyone have to follow you.
Yeah, everybody just playing D.
Yeah, so actually a lot of performance, if there is a singer and then we have a Guzheng, then it's always very a headache because especially when
have a few songs. Because singers are so limited.
Your range is so limited, right?
Sorry, singers.
No, like Guzheng.
Sorry,
singers.
Sorry, me.
So actually, the Guzheng, if you want to accompany a singer, it's very difficult to play if the singer wants to sing G sharp or
then
no, okay,
have
usually
to
sing D sharp. Sharp or
have to tune
E.
So what's the most complicated key that you have played before in a performance?
Actually, for us, it's not complicated. Just as long as we tune to that key, we we just need to know, like, you know, ba wei.
Oh, actually,
we just need to know which note is the one. Then...
Oh, it's just the one. Oh, sounds so sweet. Like,
yeah, we just need to know the one, you know?
The do.
The do. Yeah. So if we know where the do is, then we can still play the same way. We just need to write like chord one, chord five, chord all this.
Yeah. But the real limitation of the guzheng is you cannot transpose in the middle of song, right?
Yeah, then we just have to...
Oh, how it sounds like...
No, like...
Oh my god, that's...
Okay lah, no lah.
Have you ever done that?
No!
Have you done that? Like...
No, but I have a student once, right? Because she has to like press like this very fast part. After that, she had to like press. Then she went like...
Oh, yo!
The whole... Yeah, just to play that one note. That press button, then
it's already like, cannot find where is it,
we just...
Then the entire thing just...
Okay, so actually, having said that, guzheng is actually a very good accompaniment instrument. So maybe, Indra, can you like accompany a simple song?
Okay.
Then...
Maybe something slow?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you use upbeat song just now.
So that can you play and sing at the same time?
I try, okay?
I'd like to see this.
What song are you going to do? I can support you.
You have a good guitarist here. Vocalist can come up. Vocalist.
What key are you doing?
I try, okay? I try my best, okay?
Could you come at the top spot?
I'm in C.
What are you playing?
I'm playing... I cannot... Okay, I tried to sing 一个人生活.
Oh, okay.
Okay, a bit.
零凡的是不是?
对呀, but if you sing, I play, maybe I can. But then when I sing and play, I cannot concentrate. That is something that I've tried, but I never.
No,
leh.
No, because now it's like this, this, and just have to recite like some
things. Singing, you have to like you have to focus on the.
Like
the lyrics
and
the expression of
the
chord. At the same time, you think of the chord changes, yeah.
Okay.
And because of all the T, all the far right, then I will panic. My brain cannot turn.
Okay,
right, so
say
fast.
It with me now. We're not guitars.
Yeah, we are. So, yeah, lor.
Well, that was a good try, so I really learned a lot today.
Yes, yes. So.
What?
You think too then.
Oh, it's very, very, very informative. I'm learning so many things.
So anything else you want to share about, let's say if somebody wants to move away from playing traditional pieces and play...
Yeah, like, what are your pieces? Tips or your advice for people to be like you?
I think start with learning how to sing first. To me, I think for me, I teach my kids how to sing first, like really sing in tune to, especially if you're learning the guzheng, there's a lot, it's pentatonic. Uh-huh. Most of the time it's pentatonic. So learn how to sing in pentatonic because it will not go wrong. Pentatonic, because in a way the scale it is, right? You will not go wrong because of there are no dissonances in or discords in this scale. So it will sound good, and that's where they will feel confident. So firstly, learn how to sing and sing in tune.
Mm-hmm.
Sing in tune like...
Sing in tune.
Mi, re, do, re, mi. Yeah, simple tunes. When they play and sing at the same time.
That's a very good thing to do, you know. I know a lot of guitarists, they can do that, and it will really help with improvisation and really a lot of things that I get to do.
So you got to learn how to sing...
Sing what you play.
Sing what you play, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because
actually,
when you
yeah,
play,
what
it's what you,
to,
yeah,
to
in your
so,
heart,
yeah.
Ma. Mm. So I think, and it's not something that's quite easy, I feel, especially for, like to us, maybe we think, okay, what? But for kids, as in, when you want them to sing and play at the same time, especially when you want them to sing in tune, it could be something that is a bit challenging. But okay. over time, as they get used to it, right, they will get better. That's how they improve, lah. I feel. And maybe when they are listening to music, instead of listening to the melody, they can listen to the accompaniment as well. Not maybe the whole thing like dung, ding, dung, ding. Just listen to the main notes, like the main notes, the direction. How is it like? Maybe do so la fa. Yeah.
Mi
do.
Yeah.
Re. Because all these. So these are the things that they can listen out. No?
I also think that besides listening to the sound, the drum beat, listening to the drum beat. When I was learning,
for the groove.
Yeah, when I was learning guitar, you know, usually the rhythm that I play, the accompaniment is always very closely related to the drum beat. Sometimes, you know, a lot of times when you listen to pop songs, you just listen to the melody and that's it. Okay, we must learn how to, you know, don't listen to the melody, any other things besides.
Like how important these people are. Because without them, right, you know, everything is just melody.
Yes.
So the accompaniment is also
very important.
Okay.
Well, thank you, Indra, for spending the time and sharing with us alternative ways of playing Guzheng. So don't go anywhere because she'll be joining us for the last performance for tonight. So stay tuned.
Yes.
Thank you, Indra. Would you like to play us off? You have to play something.
Huh?
You want to play us off?
Yeah, I'm playing with you all.
Down, down.
All right, so let's thank Indra once again. Thank you.
Okay, so Pi Yu, can you tell us what came in over the weekend?
Is that a Guzheng tape?
No, I think it's too thick for Guzheng tape. This is a Erhu snakeskin protection tape.
Erhu snakeskin protection.
Apparently Erhu has a snakeskin protector, and the snakeskin protector needs something to protect it.
So you take an Erhu and show which part that we're talking about.
Okay, so this is the snakeskin protector.
Over here,
yeah,
it's like a plastic.
Yes, when you play the Erhu, it will get eroded down over time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you see the bow is rubbing against the snakeskin. Against the snakeskin protector.
Yes.
So a lot of Erhu players know this. They like to
put
this tape over it so that you protect the snakeskin protector from being
you
eroded.
Protector. Okay. I get what you mean now.
But there's another reason why we put this is because it has more friction. So when you play, when you bowl,
it has a better grip,
and you can get better control when you're playing slow bowing. Yes, slow pieces.
Does it minimize like the sound of the?
It actually does minimize a little bit when the bowl sometimes when it will hit against this. So with this, it will lessen some of the. Yeah, it's not so jarring, you know. Like, for example, when you use your qingzhui, it hit the sack.
Excuse me?
But if you put the cloth over it, then it will be like.
So I also have to learn from Indra how to set my
So this will be in store, and it will be $3 per day.
For old customers, they've been asking for a year already for this thing. So it's finally back. So come, drop by and get your own tape. Protector tape.
Protector tape to protect your
snake
protector.
Yeah! mouthful.
Yes.
Alright.
So that's all.
Yeah, that's all.
Alright. So we're gonna set up for the final performance, and it's been a long day. So thank you for staying with us thus far. Give us a like and subscribe to our various social media while we set up for our last song for the evening. Alright, so before we perform stuff, would you like to say a few words about the song?
Yes, okay, so today we're doing the theme song of Demon Slayer. How do you pronounce that piece?
Gurenge.
Okay, we're doing the full song, okay, the full...
Full version!
Ooh.
Yes.
Ooh.
Yeah, because the movie is coming up, so we think it's a good chance to play the song. And also have Indra here to showcase her many talents. Of course, she's not gonna scratch the Guzheng.
She's also not gonna sing.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is Demon Slayer's Gurenge in full version.
live session. And if you like what we're doing, and if you have any comments, please leave a message at the comments box below.
Yeah, so do like and subscribe to all our various social media platforms.
So to sign things off, let's also thank Indra for the game today, for the future, and also a special shout out to Shirong on the Gang Hon. And finally, I'm Anson.
And Pink.
And Rayling. And Sangwa and Mary from Easter Music. See you next week.
See you next week!